I can't believe we've come to the end of this trip.
I know, and we enjoyed a lot. Right, last 3 days were crazy.
Yeah, they were superb. I mean, this property, the Cape Goa, I think it's seriously, as the name suggests, it's literally like being in Cape Town.
Yes, absolutely.
And even our rooms, I think that, you know, extraordinary space, extraordinary interiors, and wow, what a property. Guys, if you all are watching us right now, you really have to come to Cape Goa and book your stay here. And you're going to thank me and Naisha later.
Yes, but you're going to miss that you have not met crazy Kanisha, and I've got that chance to meet crazy Kanisha. So I really enjoyed the stay as well as the company.
But Naisha, what was the highlight? What was your favorite part about this whole property?
My favorite part was the view.
Yeah.
The bathtub. The jacuzzi interview that we did. It was amazing. And the craziest part was 46 run out. So we enjoyed that a lot.
Naisha, there's just so much on this property that's worthy of you know, just falling in love with. I mean, the view, everything, the interiors.
Correct.
But what has been your most favorite?
So I'll talk about the Cape Goa first.
Yes,
the Cape Goa rooms, staff, the ambience, and the view.
And the food. Oh my god.
And the food, of course. This was fantastic. Every small detailing, you know, the bathrooms were so amazing, so naturally made, and you know, they've preserved everything that is, you know, the natural things.
Rocks,
the
trees, and cenotes, yeah.
They have, you know, made the property accordingly. And once you step down, you don't see anything. Once you step into the gate, you see that the entire field is like Cape Goa.
Yeah.
Cape Town. But that's why the name is Cape Goa, I believe. So this
even,
was the even, last
even,
property.
Even I feel like the whole, you know, intersection of modern with the, like, the wood that they've used is very sort of, you know, traditional. But at the same time, they've given it, they've balanced it so well with modernism.
Correct.
So I think a property like this, you know, it's such a mix of nature, like the mountain cenotes and washroom interiors. It's just such an amalgamation of so many things, and I think that, guys, you really have to visit the Cape Goa.
Absolutely, I recommend that highly, because you know, if you're coming to South Goa, then you should definitely visit this property, because you're going to love the views, you're going to love the property, you're going to love the staff also, because they are so welcoming.
Yeah.
They are, you know, it's amazing.
Yeah,
the entire experience is going to be very nice, because I enjoyed a lot. I'm sure Kanisha, you enjoyed it too.
Oh yeah, I mean, I was just struck by how beautiful the whole view is. Like, it's literally in the lap of nature. It's in South Goa, so it's tranquil and peaceful, and at the same time, you know, it's to die for. Just the whole way this whole place is built, you know, the interiors, the luxury, the grandeur, it's just beautiful, you know. It's I think it's one of the best properties in India that I've stayed in.
Yes,
definitely.
And especially in Goa. I've been to North Goa but you know, in South Goa, if you come, then this is, I think, the best property that you've stayed in.
Most definitely. Yes. Most definitely.
So, Kanisha, how was your itinerary basically of this entire trip?
Yeah, it's been an extraordinary last 5 days actually, because I got to cover a lot of hospitality properties, and I'm going to talk about the property I started with. So I started with Agonda Villas, which is again in South Goa, and in fact, you were there too.
Yes,
and that again is a very intimate, you know, beautiful, spacious, luxurious villa, which is overlooking the sea, and it's so peaceful and quiet. The beaches were so beautiful there. The Agonda Beach and the adjacent beach, Butterfly Beach, was so beautiful. And it was very, very different from this, but it was equally beautiful and equally luxurious.
See, what I liked about Agonda Villas was that the property, your cottages were right on the beach.
Yeah.
So you wake up and to the beach, and everything was so beautiful and so peaceful out there. So you had the entire frontage in front of you.
Yeah.
But you're also, you know, enjoying that private moment of yours because you're right there. You wake up, you come out, and you have to.
That is like literally being in the lap of the ocean, right?
Correct.
You're waking up to the sea. And out here, we got the feeling of being between. It is kind of like Santorini. It's like between being in between of being in rocks and beach, and also, you know, the whole trees and everything, you know, the palm trees and whatever. So I think that the two have very different landscapes, but both are so beautiful.
So beautiful.
So then if you're a beach person, you know, then Agonda is, you're going to love it. You're literally going to wake up to the beach. But if you're a person who loves, you know, a mix of being
Nature and views.
It's like kind of like Bahamas and all.
Yeah, right.
This sort of like, so if you want to feel Bahamas in India, Cape Town, as the name suggests. Yes. Cape Goa is the place. Then even we went to Akasa.
Akasa, yeah. Akasa was equally beautiful. I believe that
exotic.
Vegan concept that they have, food is amazing, because that was the first time that I tried in a vegan restaurant.
Yeah.
And I think the food was amazing. The food was amazing. The entire property is so amazing.
Yeah. And that had a more, I think that had a more intimate, very sweet, cute kind of a, you know, it was like having your own home.
Yes.
It was more cozy. It was more cozy. And the other thing I felt was the colors they had used were very, you know, vibrant. You know, if you remember, they were all that teal that they had used. And and also, I think what I liked about that place is that not only was it vegan, but they were growing their own vegetables. So all organic food and very different kind of food, right? Eclectic menu, which I thought was very interesting.
It was a very unique.
Very healthy. Very
Kanisha, what has been your favorite part of this entire place?
It's just been meeting some amazing people, enjoying these very, very beautiful properties, which are so eclectic and so, I mean, the kind of properties you can only, they just are made with so much imagination and love, you know. So just spending time in these.
Oh, thank you, Bom.
Oh, thanks, Bom. And meeting Bom, who's
been
such a big help, and he's taken.
Massage, Bom.
Thanks, Bom.
Thank you, Bom.
Bom has taken such good care
of
us.
Yeah, right.
With food and drinks,
you know, this personal touch is so nice, you know, because you feel so comfortable.
Yeah, absolutely. You feel very loved and
loved,
you feel very pampered. And my favorite though has been, I think, our jacuzzi portion, where we just got to enjoy so much right on the deck, you know, in the jacuzzi. It was an incredible experience. And also sitting on the deck in the evenings with the breeze literally in your face, that was my favorite.
Yeah, I think that jacuzzi was my favorite too. That was the highlight of this trip, I guess.
Yeah, that was definitely a highlight amongst a lot of other highlights, such as meeting all these incredible people. And great experience,
yeah.
We got to see a different side of Goa.
Right. And you know what, Kanisha, the cinnamon there, where we had our first lunch.
Great food. Yeah.
And the ambience was so good.
Yeah, it was literally like a shack, like being in Hawaii or something, you know. Very, again, I felt it was very exotic with the whole hay and everything that they used.
That is where we met also, right?
That's where we first met. And what I loved is that during this whole itinerary, we got to meet some amazing people.
Yes, correct.
Like even Mark, you know, the owner, the representative at Akasa Goa, he was very welcoming, a British gentleman.
Correct.
So sweet and so welcoming, and at the same time he gave us so many bits about, you know, the whole concept of the hotel, and we felt that we know everything about the hotel.
Correct.
That was interesting.
And we also got to meet this owner of the property, who was lucky, and they were, you know, they own these properties, and how they maintain it, how they initiated it, and how they are, you know, doing different things over here. And Rupesh, especially in Agonda, that personal touch by Rupesh was really, really very,
very helpful. And he customized the whole experience for us,
right.
So that's what I liked about this whole stay in Goa and all these three properties, that everything was very customized, you know. We were taken care of every step of the way, and they made sure that we are comfortable and we feel at home. I know that it sounds like a paradox, because in a hotel, how do you feel at home? But they made sure. That's what I think good hospitality is about.
You know, I think when you come out for a, you know, luxury stay, and when you want to enjoy, you know, peacefully, then you have to, you definitely want that service kind of feeling, where, you know, you don't have to worry about anything. They are taking care of your food.
Yeah.
On one call, you have everything. Yeah. And there is a personal touch also.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
So more than, you know, having that professional, there is a personal touch, and you feel like, yes, everything is so conveniently happening, and you're peaceful, you don't have to worry about anything.
True, absolutely.
From your travel to your food to everything else was, you know, so coordinated.
Yeah.
And in fact, I have to actually, you know, appreciate Stephen for, you know, sitting in Spain, and then he's managing everything so beautifully
here. That's true, that's true. And Stephen, we hope that you're happy with everything that we've done in terms of our review, because this is an honest, candid review. It's not at all something that we have. We really feel every word that we are saying. And thank you, Mark. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Rupesh. Thank you, Lucky. Thank you, everyone.
Yes.
And thank you, Raisha, and the amazing crew that is here with us, documenting this beautiful memory for us, you know.
Yes, absolutely. Big thanks to Stephen and every team and every member who was, you know, who's a part of this. Prasanna for sure, Kanisha, everybody, you know, it was a fantastic trip.
It really was. And we really recommend that you check out these properties, guys.
Absolutely.
And if you want to check out their handles, we're going to attach it in the link below. So do let us know which has been your favorite out of the footage that we've shared. And do leave your comments in the comment section below.
Yes.
This is me, Kanisha, signing off now.
Bye. This is Naisha.
Bye.